Hi, Andoni. Can we have some team news, please? Is there any updates on Luis, Dango, Kepa, anyone else?
Yes, I think the only player who will recover is going to be Kepa. Dango and Sini. Dango is doing well, but I think it's too early for him. It's just 1 week, it's small, but I think it's going to be safer to leave him to recover all the process in the national team break. Sinis is worse because he has tried and he has had like a kind of a small setback. So probably it will take more time than Dango's. And that's all I think, yeah.
What is Dango's injury?
He got a small adductor muscle injury he's not ready, but it's not something big. It's very similar to Kepa's injury. So I expect him to be ready for the next game against Brighton with the proper recovery, but Sini's case worries me more because it's more the hamstring. He has had previous injuries there, and it's one that will take more time, I think, yes.
When a player's had that injury before, it can play on the mind. How is Luis with all that?
Obviously disappointed because it was a small one. He has tried this week, he's not feeling well, and probably he will need more time. And also, I think he was in a good moment before the last international break, and he came, probably we put him straight away next game, 30 minutes against Arsenal. It's difficult to value when they flight, no? And we wanted to use him, and probably maybe it was too quick, but he knows the process. He will have to be more patient, probably, and I hope we can recover, no, the same Luis we had before, because he was performing well, yes.
With Kepa, with the pedigree he has, the reputation, everything with it, if he missed one game, it would feel very natural for him to just come straight back in. When he's missed two and Travers has played so very well, how difficult is it now to make that decision?
It's difficult for me, not only now you ask me about the goalkeepers, about every position. Every week I have difficult decisions to make, and I try to put the team that I think is going to be best to start the game. Sometimes it's not the best team, because I also have to think in the ending of the game, but natural decisions that I will have to make, and whoever I put tomorrow doesn't mean he's not going to play next one, or no, it's just we will take it game by game like we always do.
In general, I remember the City game last year, the result went against you, the performance was fantastic, and there was an effect afterwards. They'd given so much. I know you had a game in the cup, I think 3 days later, and that was perhaps affected by the City performance. When they've given so much this last weekend, how was everyone? Were there lots of tired legs, tired minds, or does the result give a boost in sort of adrenaline, fitness, everything?
I would say it's a different week, because probably at the end it's just three more points for us, important 3 points. But it's true that there is like more noise around. You know, the players receive like more recognition, they are talking more about them. But we have to focus. We play a very difficult game, I think, Brentford away. They've played 5 games. I think they have 13 points at home. So basically it's almost perfect. It's 4 wins, 1 draw at home. I think they are the fourth team scoring more goals of the competition. So basically the demands of the game are going to be super high, super, super high. So I hope we are at the level, because otherwise we will have no chance tomorrow, yes.
As far as noise, the players were in your ear after Arsenal, demanding a day off as a reward for beating them. Was there more noise from them this week? Did they demand another day off? How
no,
did you react?
They knew before that they already spent their day off against Arsenal, so against Villa and against City already. They had to come the next day to recover. I think we prepared well. I think we've tried to do our normal week. I think they've trained well. But normally you say when you lose games, the important is how you react to these games that you've lost. And now I think it's a bit of the same. how you react to those to these games that we've had good results, but probably everyone now, or a lot of people, are expecting us to drop a little bit our performance. It's the typical thing, no? You drop the performance against next week, and I hope we don't. I hope we don't, because we go to a very difficult place. I think they are a very, very difficult team to beat. We know them very well. They know us very well, but they are a super competitive team that if they beat us, they will think they are ahead of us. So they are with us more or less in the table. For us, it's a very important game, yes.
You alluded to something there last week when you said it was easy in one respect against City to have everyone at 100% focused because they knew how good City were, the champions. Are you concerned that subconsciously there might be a little drop off now?
I hope it doesn't happen, but a lot of times it happens. That you know that against City you cannot allow any inch of space, because otherwise you are going to be punished. And I hope we continue with the same intensity, the same grit, the same performance, because Brentford have players who can make the difference and who could, punish us the same way as the City players. You know, we are talking about Mbeumo has scored already 8 goals, I think. So if we are not at least at the same level, they are gonna punish us. We can see their offensive volume, their goals, especially at home, where they've been absolutely fantastic for me. And we have to reach these levels of concentration, of intensity, of performance overall, yes.
You mentioned how good Brentford are at home. You had a great point away at Villa last time out, but overall, how close are your away performances to what you're demanding and expecting?
I think we've been decent away. I think we are 5 points in 5 games against, I think, very difficult teams. I think we had difficult games, so I think we are doing well. But it's not any guarantee for the next game. You know, we have to continue performing well, being competitive. Even the games where we haven't been brilliant on the ball or we haven't been playing well, we've stayed, apart from Liverpool, in all the games. Even Liverpool game, it wasn't especially bad. I think we had our moments. And I hope we can continue. If we play like the other day and we can be the dominant team, much better. But if we are not, like it happened against Villa, we have to stay on the game, we have to stay together and still, no, be in chance to win the game, or at least to have 1 point, yes.
How do you remember the 2 games against Brentford last year? Do you shudder when you remember how they finished?
Yeah, no, they scored last minute goals in both games. It was especially the first one was hard, because it would be my first win here in the 93rd minute, something like this. No, you are winning 2-1 after a very difficult game and we almost scores, and also the last game of the season here. It's true that we were not fighting for nothing, like decisive. It's true that we finished 1 point away from the top 10, and probably that's the point that you are missing there. And but I hope we can also, we've scored some late goals recently also, so I hope this time also maybe it happens other way, yes.
As far as scoring goals, Evan Ilson now has 3. You've talked to us a lot recently about how well he is contributing everywhere. How impressive is his finishing? I think his 3 goals have all been one touch.
Yeah, he's a finisher. He's a goal scorer. I think we are starting to understand him a little bit better. He's starting to create some connections with the teammates, know also what to expect from every teammate. And I think this kind of combination are important, because once he's someone who always offers, he's always alert, offers good movements, sharp movements, trying to, especially towards the goal, and we have to be alert and knowing that in any moment we can surprise the opposition with him, because he's someone that I think he's living a lot the games, and even for quick free kicks, throw-ins, I think we can use him better, yes.
And a couple of weeks ago, we asked you about Milos Kerkez, and you said he'd improved defensively. You wanted more in attack from him. Did that light something in him? Is that why we saw his performance against City?
I don't know if that was the reason, but it's true that with the offensive volume that he provides, the normal thing is that he would have more numbers, and I hope now we could see the other day. And it's not sometimes about him only, because sometimes you, as a fullback, you cross perfect and they don't score and you don't receive the reward. But he's providing us a lot of threat there from a fullback, and I hope he continues with both things. The defensive side, where that is very important and the main thing for a fullback, and also the offensive contribution that helps a lot the team, yes.
Spoke then as if you know exactly what that's like, a fullback doing really well, putting it in, and then a striker letting you down.
Yeah, no, a lot of times it has happened. Yes, yes, I was a different fullback from Milos, but I probably was more offensive-minded than him, much worse than him defensively, definitely, but I could have more numbers than him, for sure, yes.
Just one more. Milos' decision-making when he's in that position or whatever is obviously improved. He turned up with a very striking haircut recently.
Yeah, no.
And the decision he'd made was to let Justin Kluivert do it. What would you make of that decision? And would you ever let a player have a go at your hair?
The worst thing is not the first time, you know. He did it previously in pre-season also, so I think he's also in the age that he doesn't care too much about these things, you know. And it's good to have this energy. He's someone who is sometimes too full of energy. Sometimes you have to calm him down, and even on the pitch he wants to do everything full speed, and I think he's learning, no, that okay, there are moments for everything, yes.